Hi, Pat LaFemme with Bosec.com and Deer Builder. And we are really happy with this food plot. This is a soybean plot. We've got about 36 inches of growth at least, maybe a little bit more, maybe close to 40 in some spots, but fantastic growth. So let's go through the steps it took to get to this successful step or this successful place in the plot development. The first thing we did was we did a soil test. The soil test came back and told us that the pH was perfect. It was right at 7. That's exactly where we wanted to be. We did need to apply a lot of potassium. Nitrogen was perfect. We needed a little bit of phosphorus, but we needed a lot of potassium. So we adjusted accordingly per the soil test. And remember, that's what everybody should be doing. Get your soil test and amend your soil based on the recommendations of that soil test. So when we did that, we got it perfect. These are nice and healthy. We have no evidence of any potassium deficiencies, very lush growth, good root system, so it's good. The second thing we did is after we planted the seed and firmed it up with a culture packer, we then put an electric fence up. And the reason for the electric fence is to make sure that the emerging growth, which you know could only be a foot tall or as it's coming up, didn't get hammered by the deer. Now that's a mistake we made in the past, and we learned from that mistake. So we put the electric fence up. Very simple to do. It took us 3 hours to get this electric fence up, so it's not anything elaborate, and we're going to take it down this weekend. The next thing we did is when we waited till the plot got about 8 inches tall, we actually sprayed glypho right on top of the emerging soybeans. And what that did was it killed all the weeds. These are Roundup Ready soybeans. They're impervious to glypho. So by spraying the glypho on top of these soybeans, we killed the weeds, left the soybeans. And as you can see, this is an absolute pure stand. Perfect. We've got no weed activity at all. A couple of them here and there, but you have to look hard to find them. So all these steps combined, along with adequate moisture this summer, you know, produced a fantastic food plot that we're very proud of. So now we're going to take the electric fence. We're going to let the deer get in here and start eating this. This is an unbelievable source of protein for them. We have a lot of fawns on the property. We have does that are nursing. We want to make sure that we give them all the nourishment they possibly can. The other thing, the other ulterior motive that we have to this, which we all do, right, is to drive more deer into the property. So we want all the deer from the surrounding areas to come in here and to start establishing this as their home base. The more does that we have in here, we know what happens in November. So, you know, we're hoping to get a nice concentration of deer here. We've got this plot. We've got an alfalfa plot right next to it. It's surrounded by a clover plot. This is a beautiful 10-acre field right now that's just covered with nourishment, and that's exactly what our objective was for this. So couldn't be happier. Looking forward to seeing the results once we take the fence down, and I am pretty confident that we're going to have a lot of deer activity in here.